Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add sun and light streaks to a photograph in Photoshop. I got this idea while working on a personal composite. You might have seen this if you follow me on my Behance account, behance.net/JRFromPTC. In this composite, I had to add a sun in the background. Notice that there was no actual sun in the image, so I had to create that digitally. So that's what I'm going to show you today, one of the methods that you can use to achieve a similar effect. So we're going to be working with this image here. As you can see, it's an overcast, cloudy day. And what we want to do is add the sun behind the clouds and have some sunlight, sun rays coming out of the clouds. The first thing I'm going to do is click on the brush tool, set white as my foreground color, then create a new layer by clicking on the new layer icon here on the bottom right in the layers panel. And I'm simply going to paint with white in this area here. I want the sun to be behind these clouds here. So I'm just going to paint with white. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to change the blend mode to linear dodge add, and nothing is going to happen. Everything looks exactly the same. But if we double click on the layer and bring up the layer style window, I can click on this checkbox here, transparency shapes layer, uncheck that. Notice that the blend is a little bit different now. It looks a lot hotter, a lot like the sun would look like behind the clouds, but currently this highlight is in front of the clouds, so we want to place it behind the clouds. So one way of achieving that effect is by using the blend if options and going into the underlying layer sliders. So I can hide whatever's on this layer behind dark pixels, which is what I want to do, or bright pixels on this side. But I want to use the dark luminance values of the underlying layer in this case. So I'm going to click and drag this to the right, and notice what happens. The image starts disappearing in areas that are this shade of gray or darker. And I want something like that. Now the problem is that the edges are a bit hard, but we can hold Alt, Option on the Mac, click on this icon to split it in half, and we can have the pixels disappear gradually. And all you would do now is just fine tune these sliders until you get something that works for the effect that you're going for. So maybe something like that, and press OK. If I press V on the keyboard to select the move tool, I can click and drag this around. Now the problem right now is that this edge is very sharp. So what I'm going to do now instead is select the brush tool by pressing B on the keyboard, selecting a soft brush, and increase the size of my brush by tapping on the right key on the keyboard to create a large brush like so, and painting over what I made earlier, and then pressing Ctrl T, Command T to transform, hold Shift and Alt, Shift Option on the Mac to scale this down accordingly, and maybe distort it a little bit so it fits nice in that area. So maybe add that highlight right there. And then I'll press V on the keyboard again and move it accordingly. So now we have the sun coming out of those areas. And I still don't like the way it's looking, so I'm just gonna hide just a little bit more of those pixels just so it's behind these areas there. If I click and drag this layer around the image, you'll see how it appears as if that highlight is behind the clouds. So I'm just gonna place it accordingly right about here. That's before. And that's after. What I'm going to do now is create a new layer, and with this layer I'm going to paint with white, and I'm going to use that to create the sunbeams or light streaks. So I'm going to click on the brush tool, and I'm going to decrease the size of my brush by tapping on the left bracket key on the keyboard, and I'm going to click on this icon here to bring up the brushes panel, and I'm going to click on shape dynamics and create a size jitter, scattering, increase that as well, and I'm also going to increase the spacing, and I'm actually bump the hardness all the way up, and then I'm just gonna actually make the brush even smaller and just paint like this. And that's gonna be the light coming through the clouds. Then I'm gonna go into filter, blur, radial blur, and I'm going to select zoom, increase the amount to 100%, And I'm just going to have to estimate where the center point would be. I really can't tell. I wish that Photoshop had a precise way of entering coordinates like they do with the lens flare. In this case, we just have to guess. So I'm just going to tap on here and press OK. And I'm a little bit off. So that's not going to work. So I'm going to undo that. Control-Alt-Z, Command-Option-Z in the Mac, and then press Control-Alt-F to bring up the last filter we used with options, in this case, a radial blur. And I'm just going to move it to the right a little bit and up, and then press OK. And that's pretty good. So I'm going to press Control-F, Command-F on the Mac to redo the last filter, or you can just come into Filter and click on the top option, Control-F, Command-F on the Mac. And I'm just going to press that several times just to increase the blur and it looks more realistic. So something like that. Then I can add a layer mask, paint with black with a soft brush in areas that I don't want the light streaks hitting. So for example, right up here in the far end, closer to us, and maybe some of the ones up here. If I want to hide those, I can. And now we have the light streaks and we have the sun. Now, if this is not strong enough for you, you can duplicate it. You can select it and press Control-J, Command-J on the Mac. And then use the fill to bring down the intensity. If you use the opacity and bring that down, it's gonna look flat as you see there. The linear dodge is one of 8 blend modes that has different results when you adjust the opacity compared to the fill. So I'm gonna bring that down to about 20 or 19% before and after, just a little brighter and I like it better. What I'm gonna do now is actually select the light rays, press V on the keyboard and just move them slightly over to the left and up a little bit. And that's the final effect using this technique. And actually, as I was working on this project, I thought of another way to create light rays that I figure I would take a minute and just show you how that's done. So this is sort of like a small bonus for this tutorial. I'm gonna go ahead and disable the light rays layer, and I guess I can call it original light rays, just so we know what this layer is. And we'll just leave the other two layers alone since we are going to need them for the other example. So another way to create light rays is start with a blank layer. Make sure that you have black and white as your foreground color and go into Filter, Render, Clouds, and you get a set of clouds like so. Now, if you want to create clouds that have a little more contrast, you can hold Alt Option on the Mac as you click on the clouds filter. So here I am, I'm holding Alt Option on the Mac. Sometimes you may need to hold that button before you actually click on the filter menu, but notice the difference. Now the clouds have a little more contrast, and actually I'll create a new layer and I'll do it without holding Alt or Option just so you can see the difference. So that's holding Alt. Now some people think that this is just an inversion of the clouds filter and it's not. So I'm gonna press Control-I, Command-I on the Mac to invert, and you'll notice that it is in fact clouds with more contrast. But anyway, so we have clouds with more contrast. And what I'm gonna do now is simply bring down the fill opacity just so I could see through it. And I'm gonna click on the elliptical marquee tool and just create a selection around the area where I want my light rays to be. So somewhere around here. Then I'm gonna click on the layer mask icon to create a layer mask. I'm gonna bring the opacity all the way up again to 100%. With the layer mask selected, in the properties panel, you can feather it. If you don't see the properties panel, you can go into window, properties. So feather it just a bit, something like that. Then right click on the layer mask and select apply layer mask. So now it's a layer that just contains those clouds there. Then I can go into filter, blur, radial blur, and make sure that you set the amount to 100, zoom, and we'll just try it there and see how that works. And that seems to be a good spot for it, so I'm going to just press Control-F, Command-F on the Mac to redo that filter a couple more times. Then I'm going to change the blending mode to screen, and we have our light rays. Now, they're obviously different than these light rays. It's just a different method of creating different types of light rays. So maybe you want them thin and strong or wider and softer. You can also create a levels adjustment layer, clip it to the layer below it, and then adjust the levels so you get different results with the light rays. And of course, on the light rays layer, I'll call this second light rays, just because it's the second layer of light rays. I'm gonna add a layer mask, and I'm just gonna paint with black right on the bottom here. So that's before, and that's after. This is without the levels adjustment layer, and this is with it. And this is the original. So these are just two simple methods to create light rays in Photoshop. And the reason that I decided to show you the second method is so that you can start thinking about how you can use different filters, different blending modes to create the effects that you need. And also to show you that there's not one way to do anything in Photoshop. There's many different ways of achieving the same result or similar results. So I wanted to give you more options for when you're working on your projects. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. Make sure that you leave all your comments or questions down below. If you create an image using this tutorial or any other of my tutorials, feel free to share it on Instagram with the hashtag PTCVids. I often do a search for this hashtag to see what you're all up to. If I find your image, I will leave you a comment. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click on that like button. If you have a friend who you think will enjoy this tutorial, please share this link with them now. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.